Guys, this is my Canthoscuria Gina Colada. This is a little acrylic enclosure that I just rehoused that OBT in. So he's in here right now, which is just a little deli cup. I mean, he's fine in there. But I have this and he'll grow into it, and I was able to give him a little hide, which is right over here, decorated up a little bit. So, oh, I came up with a little, I don't know if you guys use little bottle caps like this, for water dishes for your small slings, but I don't know. I've heard a lot of people talking about it. I think I've talked about it too. But you put the bottle cap in, then we tend to push down on it with the tongs or what have you, to make it sturdy so it doesn't fall over. But then what happens is, the substrate gets in it, or a bit of web gets in it, or moss or whatever's in your enclosure, and it tends to drain out because it's so close to the substrate. So what I thought of was taking two bottle caps. Just hot glue gunned it, and put a little dab on the in between here, press them together, and now we have it's firm, steady, and it's now you got the height of the one bottle cap that's away from the substrate. So I don't know, I mean, hopefully it works, but it was just a little idea I came up with, and hopefully it works. This is going to be the easiest rehouse I've done all week. If I can get the lid open. There he is. You can see him there. This little guy. He's actually, well, he or she. I got this thing, it was probably second instar. It's already molted 4 times and it's still tiny. I mean, it is growing. And it does have the adult colors and like the patterns and what have you. But yeah, I got this thing. It was so tiny. Oh, look at him burrow. I'm trying to burrow. Anyways, we'll get him in here. Condominium there. Yeah, it's big for him, but you know what? I'm okay with enclosures a little bigger as long as the tea's eating. Like I said, he's got a hide here. He can dig out a burrow if he wants as well. But I mean, even over here, he didn't dig out. I give him a little leaf to hide under. Never seen him underneath it. He was generally on top of it. So I'll just monitor him and make sure. That he's feeding well, and that he's doing okay in here. So I just put a little bit of water in here for him. He hasn't had a water dish yet. I've just been spraying his little leaf on one side of the enclosure for him, or his deli cup over here. But yeah, I think he'll be okay in here, and hopefully he starts growing because I love these guys. We actually had two of them. Like I said, they were like second instar, and I think the second molt of the other one, it didn't come out of its molt. Well, I found it dead in its molt, so I don't know if that was just it got stressed out, or I tended to keep a little bit of humidity in there for them, and I haven't had any other problems with any of my other teas molting. But I don't know. Sometimes these things happen, and it's unfortunate. But yeah, I hope this guy or girl, whatever it is, grows quick and gets big because I love them. Anyways, guys, well, thanks for watching. Well, actually, I'll pause this and I'll see if I can get a closer look at them for you before I end it. There he is. What you're seeing is his big rump, or its big rump. Yeah, there's his little enclosure, little hide, piece of wood. Big plant. piece of bark and this modified water dish. See, it's off the ground there. So hopefully that makes a difference. I mean, even with small slings like this, it's not even the tarantula's doing it, but you know, we push it, we push the bottle caps down, and it's like almost level with the substrate, you know, to make it sturdy so it doesn't flop over. So maybe that'll make a difference, and I'm gonna try it with some of my other smaller slings and see what happens. Anyways, guys, thanks for watching. Have a good evening, a great day, wherever you're at, and take care. Bye-bye.